哈利路亚，各位弟兄姐妹，大家晚安。
Hallelujah, name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Good evening to brothers and sisters.
在星期五的晚上，我们一同从圣经当中来做彼此的学习。
And on this Friday night, we'd like to use the Word of God for mutual encouragement.
我们请大家翻到路加福音的第七章。
Let's turn to the Let's first turn to the Gospel, Luke chapter 7.
路加福音的第七章。
Luke chapter 7.
第七章的二十四节。
Chapter 7, verse 24.
二十四节。
24.
约翰所差来的人既走了，耶稣就对众人讲论约翰说，你们从前出去到旷野是要看什么呢？要看风吹动的芦苇吗？二十五节。
25.
你们出去到底是要看什么？要看穿细软衣服的人吗？那穿华丽衣服宴乐度日的人是在王宫里。二十六节。
26.
你们出去究竟要看什么？要看先知吗？我告诉你们，是的，他比先知大多了。二十七节。
Verse 27.
经上记着说，我要差遣我的使者在你前面预备道路，所说的就是这个人。二十八节。
Verse 28.
我告诉你们，凡妇人所生的没有一个大过约翰的，然而神国里最小的比他还大。这一段是主耶稣谈论到施洗约翰。
So here, this passage is Jesus Christ talking about John the Baptist.
我们都知道施洗约翰是新约当中工人里面非常重要的一位。
And we know in the New Testament, among all the various workers of God, John the Baptist, is one of the most important.
他虽然一辈子没有行过神迹。
Even though in his entire life of servitude, he has not performed a single miracle.
但是主耶稣对他的评价却非常的高。
But he values John the Baptist.
在这里主耶稣说，凡妇人所生的，没有一位大过施洗约翰。
In fact, in the latter half of verse 28, he who is least in the kingdom of God is greater than he.
那为什么主耶稣会在这里要谈到施洗约翰呢？
So why is it that Jesus wants to discuss John the Baptist?
这跟第七章的第十八节有直接的关系。
In fact, there is a great correlation, a relevancy with verse 18.
我们看一下第七章的十八节。
Let's read chapter 7, verse 18.
十八节，约翰的门徒把这些事告诉约翰，他便叫了两个门徒来，打发他们到主那里去，说：那将要来的是你吗？还是我们等候别人呢？所以整件事情的开始是约翰来询问耶稣，到底是不是那个要来的弥赛亚。
So here, John himself asks Jesus, "Are you the one we are looking for?" The one coming?
我们可能会觉得约翰怎么会问这个问题呢？
So we would think to ourselves, why would John ask such a question?
约翰不是对自己的工作、自己的使命非常的清楚吗？
Is John not already very clear on his purpose?
他不是指着耶稣说，看哪，神的羔羊。
Did he not already know to look here? It's the Lamb of God.
他不是讲过那我后来来的比我更大，我连替他解鞋带都不配啊。
Does he know that the one who follows him will be greater than he? That he cannot compare.
他不是说他是旷野中的声音啊？你们听我所讲的话，你们不用看我这个人，因为我不重要。
He's just like the voice in the wilderness. All you hear is the voice, but you need not see me. I'm not important.
所以讲到认识耶稣基督，施洗约翰应当比当代任何一个人都更加的清楚。
So out of all the people who knew Jesus, John should have been the one who is most familiar.
但是这个时候被下在监牢里、被关起来的约翰却问出了一句话， 到底是不是你呀？
But here John, after being locked up in prison for all this time, he would still ask such a question.
所以这里是不是约翰啊？因为在患难当中，在监牢里面，所以他开始有疑问呢？
Is it because he's been locked up for so long, he started having his own doubts?
或者是因为他的人生已经要到结束，被关在牢里，所以他必须再次确认他的认知是正确的。
Or is it because his life is about to end and he knew this, so he wanted to make sure of this Jesus Christ?
要来确定说他一辈子的追求，一辈子的努力是正确的目标，有真正的盼望。
Perhaps he wanted to confirm that everything he has been pursuing after his entire life is true, is real.
这个我们没有办法百分之一百的确认。
There is no way we can absolutely confirm either of these, any of these options.
但是不管是什么原因，
But however, no matter what reason,
约翰的心中他有了一个问号。
In his heart, he had a question.
他必须要确认自己所信的是谁。
He wanted to make sure of who this person he believed in was.
所以他虽然人在监牢，仍然派人去询问耶稣。
So even though he was in the prison, he had someone ask this question.
今天信仰的路上，有时候难免我们都有可能产生一些问号。
So in our own individual walks of faith, we may also come across some questions.
平常平安顺利的时候，要维持信心并不困难。
When our lives are smooth, we may not encounter any difficulty.
但有时候人生遇到意外，或者是突然遭到患难，我们会不自觉地打出一个问号来。
But however, during times of conflict or affliction or during difficulty, we may have questions.
你会问说，为什么是我？
We may ask, why me?
为什么是我生病？
Why is it, why me? Why is it me who has gotten ill?
为什么是我？
Why me?
为什么是我失去工作？
Why me to lose my job?
为什么是我？
Why me?
为什么我失去家人？
Why me to lose my family members?
所以常常是在这个遇到患难当中，我们的信仰面对最真实的考验。
So during these times of trouble and tribulation, this is when our faith is tested.
然后我们在不断的责备自己说，我是小信的，我怎么没有信心？
And then we end up not only questioning, but we also rebuke ourselves of such little faith.
但是你从约翰的身上你看见。
But here, from John's perspective, you can see.
如果约翰会产生问号，那你我产生问号是很正常的。
If John himself had questions, then us having questions should be considered normal.
有问号没关系，一定要表现一副我就是信心很好，绝不怀疑的样子。
There's nothing wrong with having questions. There's nothing to cast doubt.
所以有问题这个有怀疑、有质疑。不是真正的问题。
So having doubts or having these questions is not the root of the problem.
那问题是在当你有疑问，当你不明白，当你问神说为什么的时候，你怎么去解决你的问号？
The root of the matter is when you have these types of questions or when you encounter these conflicts, what you do next is the important piece.
所以约翰就来找耶稣，把自己的问题放在耶稣的面前。
So here, John had a question, and he presented his question, his problem to Jesus himself.
他也从主耶稣那里得到了他所需要的答案。
And from Jesus Christ himself, he received his answer.
所以在这里当约翰的门徒离开，主耶稣开始谈论施洗约翰这个人。
So as soon as the disciples left Jesus began discussing John the Baptist.
其实在这一段耶稣谈论施洗约翰是今天给你我一个很重要的信仰侍奉上的自我反思。
So here, in these passages where Jesus discusses John the Baptist, it will serve as a great teaching in our own lives.
在当代，约翰是一个非常非常受到重视，而且有极高声望的一个工人。
John the Baptist was highly regarded in his time.
所以很多人跟随他，跟着他到旷野来接受他的洗礼。
In fact, so regarded that people would follow him into the wilderness to become baptized.
到旷野跟随他，听他讲道，跟随他来接受他的洗礼啊。
To follow him into the wilderness, to hear the word of God, and to be baptized.
所以约翰在当时是个这个声势浩浩荡荡、受到众人尊重的一个先知。
So he was a prophet, that was highly revered by people.
但是在这里，当主耶稣谈到这个大工人，谈到这许许多多来跟随约翰的人。
So here Jesus discusses all the various types of people who followed John the Baptist.
来告诉他们说，是的，约翰很好，是的，约翰很重要，是的，约翰是神家重用的工人。
Yes, John the Baptist is wonderful. Yes, he is great. Yes, he is a great worker of God.
但是你跟随他，不代表你能够像他一样被神所重视。
But just by following him,does not guarantee that you will also be seen by God himself.
虽然很多人跟随他，走到旷野听他讲道，跟随他四处而行。
So all these people who followed him into the wilderness,
但是如果你不知道自己为什么跟随约翰，
but if you, lack the understanding of why you're following,
那你所做的，所付出的努力，所做的工作都没有太大的价值。
Then all the effort and all the time and effort you put in actually diminishes in value.
跟随约翰是这样，跟随耶稣是这样，今天我们来教会聚会信神也是这样。
Following John the Baptist or following Jesus Christ is this way. It is also this way for us here today coming to church.
不是有人讲说，主啊主啊，我们听你讲道，我们看你。我们奉你的名讲道，奉你的名传，奉你的名行神迹，我们在你面前吃过喝过。
Do people not boast about them being able to come before Jesus or before our Lord and hear his words and to eat of his and to dine with him?
主耶稣说话，说你们这些作恶的人。
How did Jesus respond? He responded then by saying, "You evildoers, depart from me."
所以在这里，主耶稣告诉那些跟随他的，或者是跟随约翰的人，告诉他们说，你要跟随，你要知道自己在做什么。
So the point here is that if you choose to follow, then you must understand why you're following.
所以在这里，第一个主耶稣问他们的第一个问题呀。
So here Jesus asks.His first question.
主耶稣在第二十四节问他们说，你们从前出去到旷野是要看什么？要看风吹动的芦苇吗？在这里主耶稣问他们第一个问题呀。
So in verse 24, Jesus asked them his first question.
我们不要忘记了，在当代跟随约翰的人可不比跟随耶稣的少哦。
And that anyone who
在那个时代，跟着约翰的人可能比耶稣比跟随耶稣的人要多啊。
And those who followed John actually may have been greater in number than those who followed Jesus himself.
为什么？
Why is that?
你不要忘记，耶稣是穷木匠家庭出身的，约翰是祭司家庭出身的。
Let's not forget that Jesus was born into an impoverished family, whereas John the Baptist was the complete opposite.
所以圣经里特别讲他发约翰的爸爸是祭司，他的妈妈是亚伦的后裔啊，根正苗红啊，血统纯正。
In his genealogy, John came from the family of Aaron, and his father himself was a high priest.
所以呢，这个主耶稣跟约翰他们都受到普通百姓的尊重。
And so so during his time, he was revered just like all the other disciples.
但是同时施洗约翰是被上流社会所接纳的哦。
But what sets him apart, what sets John apart is that the society reveres, highly regards him.
啊，因为他也是跟他们一样，这个啊是啊这个祭司家庭上层社会出来的人。
Because he is an offspring of a priest, and was highly educated.
啊，所以很多人啊非常的佩服约翰，很多人在跟随约翰。
So there were a great number of people following John and respecting John.
啊，但是在这里主耶稣问他们说，你跟着他，你跟着他到旷野。
So Jesus in verse 24 asks, when you go out into the wilderness, what is it that you're trying to see?
你是要去看那风吹的芦苇吗？
Are you trying to see a reed being shaken by the
wind? 为什么这里要特别讲一个什么叫做风吹的芦苇？
What does it mean, a reed shaken by the wind?
啊，我们看过那芦苇啊，这个很轻，所以风一吹，风往哪边吹，它就往哪边倒啊。
We know reeds are very light and weak, and they will go where the wind blows.
啊，所以啊，他从来不坚持啊，随左边也好，右边也没关系。你要我往哪边倒，我就往哪边倒啊。
Reeds, they don't necessarily care where they fly. They may fly left, fly right. They go with the flow.
啊，所以在这里，主耶稣用一个自然界的植物现象来形容那时有些人的人心呐。
So here, Jesus uses this example of the reed shaken by the wind to serve as an example for some types of people.
啊，虽然跟着约翰，但是从来不知道自己为什么走到旷野。
Even though they carry out the action of following John, they don't know why they're following him.
啊，今天喊跟随约翰，明天就可以放弃约翰。
Today, they may follow John, but tomorrow,they may forsake him.
那其实，在那个时代，有很多人都是这样。
In fact, during that time, many were like this.
哦，就是什么纯粹的看热闹。哦，这里好热闹，那里好好玩。哎，发生什么事情，赶快就跑过去看呐。
Some people may be interested, and they start following just because everyone else was doing the same thing.
啊，但是啊，从来没有扎根，信仰没有根基，所以跟了半天也不知道自己。为什么要来看约翰？
But these types of people were not deeply rooted in their faith, so they lacked the understanding of why they were following to begin with.
当主耶稣进入耶路撒冷圣城的时候，
When Jesus entered the city of Jerusalem,
啊，圣经里面告诉我们说，何曾轰动大家来看，高喊啊，这个啊高啊把衣服丢在地上啊，然后高喊何塞纳。
And we know the people came when they heard the news, and they gathered and they tore off their clothing and shouted, Hosanna.
啊，大卫的子孙，大卫的子孙，啊，喊得非常激动啊。
And they shouted with extreme excitement, Hosanna, Hosanna, the son of David.
啊，但是啊，在一个星期之后，那个喊着钉死他，钉死他的，也就是这一群人啊。
But let us not forget that a mere week later, the same people were also crucifying him on the cross.
啊，他们喊啊，反正就是人家喊什么，我就跟着喊啊。
So these people just follow the crowd. They follow whatever other people do.
啊，但是啊，喊了半天也不知道自己在喊什么。
So they're not only they're crying out, whatever they're crying out, they don't realize the meaning behind it.
别人喊说君王来了，何塞纳，你就跟着乱喊。
If the crowd around you shout Hosanna, the king of the soldier king has arrived, they'll also shout the same.
啊，一个礼拜之后啊，人家喊啊，钉死他，你喊钉谁啊？钉管他钉谁啊？钉死他就对了。
And a week later, the crowd changes their stance and shouts, "Crucify him!" And you just go along and follow them.
啊，这就叫做风吹的芦苇啊。
All these types of people are just like what Jesus said.
今天好像在信耶稣啊，今天好像信耶稣，信了很长，跟着大家去教会，但是信了半天，你也不知道自己在信什么。
Some people may come to church, may claim they believe in God, yet after all these years, not really know why.
啊，我们来看雅各书的第一章。
Let's turn to James chapter 1.
雅各书的第一章。
James chapter 1.
第一章的第六节
，Chapter 1, verse 6。
第六节
，James chapter 1, verse 6。
只要凭着信心求，一点不疑惑，因为那疑惑的人就像海中的波浪，被风吹动翻腾。第七节
Verse 7,
这样的人不要想从主那里得着什么。第八节
8,
心怀恶意的人在他一切所行的路上都没有定见警念。
James chapter 1 verse 6, But let him ask in faith with no doubting, for he who doubts is like a wave of the sea driven and tossed by the wind. Verse 7, For let not that man suppose that he will receive anything from the Lord. Verse 8, He is a double-minded man, unstable in all his ways.
在这里雅各长老告诉我们，当你信仰没有定向，你到最后就是一无所获。
So here, the elder James says very clearly that if your faith is not deeply rooted, then you just become very unstable.
这里所讲的人就如同风吹的芦苇一样。
And this type of person described here is just like that reed shaken by the wind.
所以主耶稣在这里问这些人说，你们到旷野，你们到底要看什么？
So Jesus asked the multitudes, when you follow John into the wilderness, what is it, why is it that you're following him?
你说你要看约翰，请问你要看约翰什么？
You said you want to go see John the Baptist. Why do you want to see John the Baptist?
你今天说你跟随耶稣，你跟随耶稣，你要什么？
Today you say you follow Jesus Christ. Why is it that you're following him?
那因为只有清楚明白自己的目标，你才知道要奔跑哪一条道路。
So you must have a very clear understanding of why you're doing such a thing before you start on this journey.
所以在这里是主耶稣问的第一个问题。
So here is the first question that Jesus asked the multitudes.
我们看回来路加福音的第七章。
Let's now turn back to the Gospel,
chapter 7,
chapter 7, verse 25.
在这边主耶稣问他们第二个问题。
Here he asked the multitudes a second question.
25节说，你们出去到底要看什么？要看穿细软衣服的人吗？那穿华丽衣服宴乐度日的，是在王宫里。所以在这里主耶稣问他们第二个问题。
So here, Jesus Christ asked the multitudes his second question.
或者是说他一样的问题又再问了一次。
Or maybe you can see it as it's the same question asked twice.
主耶稣第二次问说，你们到旷野，你们到底要看什么？
Jesus asked them, when you went out to the wilderness, what did you want to see?
你们是要看那个穿着华丽、身份高贵、超人一等的上流人士吗？
Is it you wanted to see someone gorgeously apparelled and living in luxury?
这主耶稣告诉你说，如果你想看这个，如果你要找这样的人，你走错地方了。
So Jesus would say, if this is what you wanted to see, then you're going in the wrong direction.
如果你找约翰是想要从约翰身上得到好处，你什么都得不到。
If you are trying to seek benefit from John the Baptist, then you are seeking in vain.
如果你来跟随耶稣是想要得到耶稣身上带来给你的利益，很抱歉，你只会得到失望而已。
If the only reason why you're following Jesus Christ is to receive great benefits, then you have come to the wrong place.
所以在这里主耶稣告诉我们说，你要确定你要看什么，你才知道你要去哪里。
So Jesus is very clear in what he is trying to say. Before, you must know where you're going before you start going.
如果你是希望得到一些利益，希望得到一些好处。
If you're just merely seeking for some self-benefits,
那你今天来到这里，很抱歉，你走错地方了。
And if that's what you're seeking after, and you're here today, then I'm sorry, you've come to the wrong place.
曾经有一个教会的姐妹，很早很早就到美国来。
There is a story of a sister who immigrated to the United States.
然后她来得很早，所以她住的那个城市或者那一个州那一整州，那时候还没有真耶稣教会。
And she came many years ago, so during that time, there was no established True Jesus Church in her state.
所以她查了一下，找了一下，问了一下，没有，没有就没有办法了。
And she did some research, and she asked around, and there was no established church at the time.
所以很多年过去了，很多年过去了。
Then many years passed.
那这个姐妹她是做旅行社的，就是在买机票啦，做这个旅行团的啊，这个在旅行社工作的。
So this sister was a travel agent.
啊，有一天她在处理啊订单的时候啊，这个啊收到的支票让她多看了两眼。
And when she was trying to book a vacation for a client, she received a check and she had to take a second look at it.
啊，这买机票哈，啊一看，哎出。Church, 他就多看了两眼，然后自己把它从英文翻成中文啊。
So she looked at the check and it was written out by True Jesus Church, and she had to take a second glance.
啊，他说哇，那个时候啊，他突然心跳加速，说会吗？会是我的教会吗
？And she questioned herself, "Is this true? Is this the church? Is this my church?"
因为他其实已经来美国非常多年，而且太多年了，他就没有想到说，原来教会已经。在他的城市已经有真耶稣教会，他不知道。
Because she had already come for many years, and after all these years, she did not realize that a church had already been established in her hometown.
啊，所以呀、啊，很紧张，又期待，又怕受伤害，然后去打电话啊，打电话去问说，你们是真耶稣教会吗？
So she was excited yet frightened at the same time. But she called the number on the check to confirm if they were the True Jesus Church.
那然后就是这样子，哎，找到教会，重新开始聚会哦。
And this is how she found her church and returned to church.
那她的先生不是教会的信徒。
Now her husband was not a believer.
那也跟着她来教会好几次啊。
In fact, he had already come to the church many times.
那有一次啊，有一次她的先生就跟她说。
And one time, her husband asked her,
他说、啊、这间教会不行啊。
That this church is no good.
啊，他很生气哦，很生气啊！你怎么可以讲我的教会不好？
So when she heard this, she was extremely angry. How can you say such a thing about my church?
他先生说不是啦，不是这样啦，啊。
So her husband said, "No, that's not what I meant."
他说哇、啊，你如果想要卖机票赚 commission， 你要换一间教会，这间教会不行。
So he clarified his point that if you were to be a travel agent, selling vacations and airline tickets, earning commission, then you must find a different church.
他说你们教会都没有，因为他说你们教会都没有在讲这种什么拉关系做生意啊，这个互相的这种人际人脉。他说你们教会从来不讲这个。
Because your church never discusses about interpersonal relationships.
那所以他先生跟他讲说，信耶稣你可以留在这里，你想要哦赚 commission 哦。你要换教会，这间教会不行啊。
So he said, if you want to believe in Jesus, then this is the church. But if you want to make more money and earn more commission, then you need to find another church.
那因为今天有许许多多的人，他们虽然来教会，但是他们并不是来找耶稣的。
So this is a clear example that many people claim they're Christian, but they go to church not seeking after God.
那所以你看，可能社会上的这些名人名人啊，上流人士啦、啊，这个亿万富翁啊，他们去的地方，人家都特别想去。
So you think about it, there are famous people today, there are influencers today, and people like to go where they go.
哎，说不定我就在我就在这个他的 club 里面，我们就变成好朋友啊。
Perhaps if they join the same club or organization.Then they can claim that they are friends.
啊，说不定我跟他成为同样一个教会的教友，他就可以给我什么机会，或者给我什么内部消息呀。
Or perhaps if I join his or her church, then I can find out more secrets to his or her success.
啊，所以今天有许许多多的人，虽然打着耶稣的名号，但是却是在寻找那穿华丽衣服的人。
So today there are many people who claim that they are Christians, yet all they are going pursuing after is luxury and these gorgeously apparel.
啊，但是在这里，主耶稣说，如果今天你为了这个，那你走错地方了。
So Jesus is very clear in his point that if this is what you are pursuing after, then you have come to the wrong place.
因为这不是你走到旷野看约翰的原因。
Because this is not why you would follow John into the wilderness.
更不是你今天来到教会信耶稣的目的。
Moreover, this is not why you would come to the church today.Pursue after God.
那我们来看腓立比书的第三章。
So let's turn to Philippians chapter 3.
腓立比书的第三章。
Philippians chapter 3.
啊，第三章的第十八十七节哦。
Chapter 3, verse 17.
17节,
17.
弟兄们, 你们要一同效法我, 也当留意, 看那些照我们榜样行的人。18节,
18.
因为有许多人行事是基督十字架的仇敌, 我屡次告诉你们, 现在又流泪地告诉你们。 19节,
19.
他们的结局就是沉沦, 他们的神, 就是自己的肚腹, 他们以自己的羞辱为荣耀, 专以地上的事为念。 请念。
Philippians chapter 3, verse 17. Brethren, join in following my example and note those who so walk as you have us for a pattern. Verse 18. For many walk, of whom I have told you often, and now tell you even weeping, that they are the enemies of the cross of Christ. Verse 19. Whose end is destruction, whose God is their belly, and whose glory is in their shame, who set their mind on earthly things.
那所以在这里保罗特别告诉我们，在当时有许多的人啊，这个是基督十字架的仇敌呀。So
here, Paul discusses these. There are some people here that are the enemies of the cross of Christ.
那说为什么呢？因为他们的神是自己的肚腹啊，肚子啊，肚子是他们的神啊。Because
their God is their own belly.
啊，什么叫做以肚腹为神？
So what does that mean? That their God is their belly.
啊，就是满足自己的欲望，得到自己的贪恋。我要什么？我要得着我想要的利益好处。这就是以肚腹为神啊。What
this means is that they prioritize themselves. They prioritize filling their own belly, filling their own satisfaction.
那在这里讲的不是外邦人哦。
So here it does not talk about non-believers, it does not talk about Gentiles. He is talking about those who claim to be believers already. Because he says at the end of verse 19 that they have set their mind on the earthly things.
如果一个人没有信仰，没有耶稣，他以世上的事为念，这叫做很正常啊，没什么好讲的。
Because if you think about it, any non-believer, if their mind is set on earthly things, then that is normal for them.
他们就是灵性上的死人，没有什么需要再讨论什么基督十字架的敌人呐。These
types of people who don't believe are already spiritually dead. There's no point in discussing heavenly things about with them.
所以在这里讲的是看起来在信耶稣的人。So
here Paul is discussing those who put on a show, claiming that they are Christians.
所以一个人如果信耶稣，只在今生，只在世上有指望，说这比众人都可怜啊。So
his point here is that those who claim they are Christian, yet their hearts on earthly things, they are even more pathetic than those who don't believe.
那所以我们今天走到旷野来看耶稣。So
Jesus,
So
here today we go into the wilderness to go see Jesus.
那主耶稣就要问我们一个问题，说你到底出来要看什么？
So Jesus asks each and every one of us, why is it that you have come out here to find me?
你是要看那个衣着华美，这个能够给你带来好处，能够给你带来利益的人吗？
Are you searching for wealth and prosperity, so and your own benefits?
那你走错地方了，因为这里没有。
Jesus would tell us, you have come to the wrong place because none of that can be found here.
所以要信耶稣，你就要很清楚地知道你到底出来看什么。
So if we claim to be believers and to be Christians, we must be very clear in our purpose.
我们看回来路加福音的第七章二十六节。
Let's turn back to the Gospel of Luke chapter 7, verse 26.
路加福音7章26节，第三次主耶稣又重复地说。
In verse 26, Jesus asks the same question a third time.
26节说，你们出去究竟要看什么？要看先知吗？我告诉你们，是的，他比先知大多了。所以你看，主耶稣越问，语气越重哦。So
you can see,
越来越strong 啊。
So you can see that with every time he asks, his emphasis grows stronger.
一开始说你们要看什么？
First, he will ask, what is it that you seek after?
你们到底要看什么？
What is it that you're looking for?
你们究竟出来，你到底要看什么？
You have come out all this way. What is it that you want?
因为这个问题实在是太重要了。
Because this question is very important.
好，约翰福音一开始有两个门徒来跟着耶稣，耶稣没有说啊，你们跟着我就对了，没有。
So in the beginning of the
of this, 我们看约翰福音啊第一章哦。
In the beginning of John, Jesus did not just say, oh, just come follow me for whatever reason. Let's turn to Gospel John chapter 1. 约翰福音第一章哦。Gospel John chapter 1.
啊，第三十七节。
Verse 37.
啊，这里讲说两个门徒听见他的话就跟从了耶稣。三十八节。
38.
耶稣转过身来看见他们跟着就问他们说你们要什么，请念。
Verse 37. The two disciples heard him speak and they followed Jesus.Verse 38, then Jesus turned and seeing them following, said to them, what do you seek?
所以我们有没有看到对耶稣来讲这个是至关重要的问题。
So do you not already see the importance of these types of these questions from Jesus?
你信耶稣你到底要什么？你到底希望得着什么？
You believe in God for what? Why do you come and to believe in God?
第三，这里讲说你是出来看先知的吗？
So in verse 26 of Luke chapter 7, is it a prophet that you seek after?
你可能会觉得说这个答案正确，这个答案很好，对不对？
You may think, oh, of course, I'm here to see a prophet. You may think you are right.
主耶稣说，你是出来看先知吗？
So Jesus asks, are you here to come to see a prophet?
是的。
Yes.
请问这个答案对不对？
So I ask, is this the right answer?
你会觉得说主耶稣说是的啊，那答案是对的啊。
Of course, you would think it's correct because Jesus said so.
不对。
Unfortunately, you were wrong.
这里的是的是告诉你说方向正确。
His yes means that you are going in the right direction.
好像我们告诉小朋友说 good.
Just like we tell a little child, whatever they have done is good.
说你是为了看先知而出来，至少你的方向是对的。是的。
So yes.You come to the wilderness to seek after a prophet, that is right, that is good.
你不是出来看热闹，搞不清楚状况。
You're not here to come seek for excitement or some sort of event.
你也不是想要得到世界上的利益，物质上的好处。
You're here to see a prophet, not earthly wealth.
所以主耶稣说，是的，这是对的方向。
So Jesus praises them by saying, yes, this is the right direction.
但是后面那一句话告诉你说，不是的，你的认知还不够。
But the latter half of his answer, more than a prophet, means, but you are still wrong.
所以如果看先知是对的，主耶稣就不需要加后面那一句话了。
Because if coming to see a prophet is right, then he need not finish his statement that with more than a prophet.
因为在后面讲说他比先知大多了。
Because he is greater than a prophet.
为什么施洗约翰比先知大多了？
Why did Jesus say that John the Baptist is greater than a prophet?
其实这句话跟后面的二十八节也很有关系啊。
And this statement is very related to verse 28.
其实很多人对二十八节常常有很多的问号。
In fact, verse 28 carries many questions by believers.
主耶稣说，凡妇人所生的没有一个大过施洗约翰。
That among those born of women, there is not a greater prophet than John.
但是后面加一句说，天国里最小的比他大。
But he finishes his statement with, but he who is least in the kingdom of God is greater than he.
所以到底约翰是大还是小？
So,This is confusing, is it not? Is John great or not?
天国里最小的比他大，我觉得我会进天国，那我比约翰还大哦。
Jesus says those.
如果是我们这样想哈。
If this is how we think,
天国里最小的都比约翰大。
If the smallest in is the least of these in heaven is greater than John the Baptist, then
我是天国的人呐、我应该比约翰大啊。
Then I am guaranteed to go to heaven, so I should be greater than John the Baptist.
那你就进入一个那个逻辑，因为他前面还有一个凡妇人所生啊，你是不是妇人所生的？
Because Jesus said, among those born of women, are you not all born of women?
所以我们这些能够进天国的人，难道我们不是妇人所生的吗？
So if all these people can go to heaven, can we not do the same?
你如果不确定，你去问 Vivian， 通通都是妇人所生的。
If you are unsure of whether you're born of a woman, then you can ask our house obstetrician.
哦，通通都是我们，通通都是妇人所生。
We are all born of women.
我们到底是比约翰大还比约翰小？
So the question is, are we truly bigger or greater than John the Baptist?
这一句话从来不应该这样去看。这句话不是这样子去看的。
How we perceive this statement is incorrect.
他这句话不是在告诉你去跟约翰比一比，跟亚伯拉罕比一比，谁大谁小啊？
Jesus Christ, his point was not to compare whether or not we're greater than John the Baptist.
他的其实是在告诉我们一个时代的差别。
He is he is telling us
一个 generation 一个 era 一个不同的时代的差别。
He is discussing and describing a generational gap.
约翰在耶稣之前就约翰在耶稣的耶稣钉十字架之前就离世了。
So we must remember that John the Baptist passed away before Jesus Christ was crucified on the cross.
所以他本身并没有那个机会真正接受耶稣基督的宝血，真正体会到那个永远同住的圣灵，他没有这个经验。
So John did not experience the remission of sins by Jesus Christ's blood.
所以它只是一个时代的差别，告诉我们说，今天我们这些后来的人是真正蒙福的人。
So here Jesus is discussing this generational difference that we are the offspring, the descendants.
那为什么要提这一件？为什么要提这一点呢？
So why did Jesus make this point?
因为这也回到说，为什么凡妇人所生的没有一个大过施洗约翰？为什么？
And this is why he said, any born of women is greater than John the Baptist.
不是哦，凡妇人所生的没有一个比他大哦。
That any among you, a born of women, is not greater than John the Baptist.
这也不是叫你把约翰拿来跟摩西比一比，跟亚伯拉罕比一比。跟那个以利亚比一比，这个没有一个哦，亚伯拉罕也没有他大哦，不是叫我们做这种事情。
The point here is not to compare about our forefathers in Abraham or David or Elijah.
摩西那位特殊的先知。
Moses was a very special worker of God.
以利亚叫做烈火先知，叫火从天上下来。
Prophet Elijah was sent down from heaven in flames.
所以你如果讲妇人所生，然后你把这些人再拿来比来比去，这是没有意义的事情。
So if you're trying to compare amongst human beings born of the flesh, all this is meaningless.
亚伯拉罕被称为信心之父，你怎么去比较？
Abraham himself is known as the father of faith.
摩西叫做全然尽忠的仆人，你怎么比较？
Moses，
全然的 the most faithful worker 哦。
Moses was known as the most faithful worker. How can anyone compare to him？
所以一样，这句话的意思是时代的问题。
So in the same vein, all this is a generational difference.
为什么？他比先知大多了。为什么施洗约翰是先知，但是他比先知大多了
？Why is it that the least in the kingdom of heaven of God is greater than John the Baptist？
因为他有特别的机会成为耶稣基督的开路先锋，就是这样子而已。
Because he merely opened the doors to
pave the way.
He paved the way. For Christianity and all those who follow behind him.
所以在这里他特别告诉我们说，因为约翰的侍奉是在耶稣前头为他开路，所以他比先知，比其他那些没有机会走在，没有机会为耶稣铺路的先知大多了。
So this is why he is greater than all the other prophets, because he was considered a forefather.
啊，就好像在彼得前书，彼得说，过去很多先知他们想要看，他们在考察弥赛亚什么时候会来，但是从来没有发生在他们的时代。
Just like Peter, he would mention about the Messiah and everything that had happened during that time, yet did not happen in this time.
啊，所以很多你们啊，很多他们想看到的，他们没有看到，因为耶稣没有降生在那个时代。
Everything that they have seen was not seen before because Jesus had yet to come.
啊，但是到了耶稣的时代，施洗约翰有这个特殊的机会、特殊的荣耀，能够成为开路先锋，这是他比先知大多了的原因啊。
But during the time of John the Baptist, that was when Jesus was on this earth, and he, because of that experience, he was greater than other prophets.
所以这个大不是说他比别人伟大。
So greater than other prophets does not mean he is better than them.
不是说他比别人更高啊，不是啊。
Nor does it mean he would be bigger or taller than them.
而是因为他得以亲眼看见耶稣。
It's because he saw for his own eyes Jesus Christ. He, with his own bare hands, opened and paved the way for Jesus Christ.
所以这个大对他来讲是一个机会啊，这个有这个机会，有这个荣耀，福气大多了。
So this greater than is speaking about the blessings he received for this opportunity.
好，那再回到我们的身上。
So now we think back, now we move forward and think about ourselves.
好，主耶稣在问我们，你究竟出来你要看什么？
If Jesus asks you, why are you here today?
啊，说你只是来看先知的吗？
Are you just here to see a prophet?
啊，这个道理不错啦，这个安慰人心啦，啊，这个耶稣蛮好啦，叫人家行善啦，都蛮好的，都蛮好的。
Yes, it's true and it's right that we must be good, a good person on this world, in this world, and good to others.
啊，你走到旷野，你来跟随耶稣，你要看到的是，只是说他是个好人，只是说啊，信耶稣不错，只是说啊，教会啊，小朋友来教会，宗教教育不会变坏。那这是你所寻找的吗？
So do you come to church because it's good to be a Christian? It's good to be a good person? It's good to have your children understand God so that they become good adults.
啊，还是说，因为你看到他比先知大多了，你知道走到这一条路上，你能够看到救恩的门路，所以你来了。
Or is it because you see that Jesus is greater than all of these, and that you can earn your way into heaven by coming here?
啊，所以在这里，主耶稣问我们每一个人三个问题呀。
So here Jesus asks the same question three times.
第一个问题是，你知道你为什么来教会吗？
The first question is, do you know why you come to church?
第二个是，你知道你为什么信耶稣吗？你信耶稣你要得到什么？
The second question is, do you know why you believe in Jesus?
第三个问题是，你认识你所敬拜的耶稣吗？你所敬拜的神吗？
The third question then is, do you recognize and understand this Jesus that you worship?
啊，从城市走到旷野。
So from the city to the wilderness.
它本身是要额外的付出，你需要放弃一些事情，你需要付出一些努力的。
It actually takes quite a bit of effort.
啊，走到旷野，你要放下城市里的好处，你要离开这个舒适的环境。
To go into the wilderness, you must give up on your comfortable lifestyle and all the pleasantries of
city. 就好像今天信耶稣，你要走旷野路，你必须要付上一些代价。
So just like to embark on this journey to follow Jesus in the wilderness, you must make some sacrifices.
但是有一件事非常重要。
But there is one very important
thing. 我们要常常祷告当中告诉自己，主啊，求你不要让我白白受苦。
And you ask a very important question. And when you pray, you ask Jesus, please, Jesus, do not let me suffer in vain.
不要让我走到旷野，但是两手空空，一无所获的离开。
Do not allow me to follow you into the wilderness empty-handed.
你可以看到先知。
Yes, you can see a prophet.
但是你要看到他比先知大多了。
But more importantly, you must see that he's greater than a prophet.
一起来唱诗啊。
Let's sing him.
我们一起唱诗84首。
84.